Hi, I'm Sam. I'm an artist, graphic designer, and illustrator from Leicester, England. I like traveling, creating, cooking, going to the game, jumping in the water, and stuffing my face. In early 2023, I decided to put all my stuff into storage, sell my car, and go traveling, embracing life as a digital nomad, flying around the world and working remotely in other countries. So far, it's been a blast. I've been making memories, exploring different cultures, and embracing different ways of life. I've made a bunch of new friends, had a bunch of visitors from back home come out to stay with me, tried local cuisines, fell into tourist traps, and had way too much sunshine. Some of my favourite days since I've been away are the days where I've put the iPad in a bag, gone for a wander until I've found somewhere to post up, enjoying the scenery and drawing something. So I want to bring you with me as I document my journey and try to adjust to life on the move, finding inspiration and living my dream of working and travelling, drawing and exploring. What's happening, people? Welcome to another episode of Drawing and Exploring with me, Sam Grubb. Today I'm in Sarajevo, the capital of Bosnia. Been here for about 2-3 days, and straight away I'm getting a really cool vibe. I'm getting a big city vibe, capital vibe. There's metro, there's trams, bunch of yellow cabs all over the shop, bunch of city slickers when you head into the city, and a load of huge bank and insurance skyscrapers and stuff. Nice cafe culture, loads of graffiti, which is cool. But yeah, enjoying it so far. There's a, 270,000 people live in the city, and in the wider areas, there's 555,000 people. And I think it's going to be a cool couple of weeks that I've got here. So there's a bunch of history. It's an old town. There's a load of scars left over from the war. You can see kind of gunshot holes in the buildings and stuff like that. I'm really excited to get out there and explore. But yeah, today I've got a really cool one. So I think I'm going to go paint some graffiti. I did a little bit of research, and there's an abandoned bobsleigh and luge track from the 1984 Winter Olympics that Sarajevo hosted. So I'm going to find my way up to there. Apparently you go up via cable car, which is cool because I like to tick off a cable car ride, and it was definitely one of the things I wanted to do while I was here. So it's nice that it's just going to be a natural part of today heading up there. And I found a graffiti shop that's inside a mall that's not too far away. So right now you join me as I'm on my way to this graffiti shop. I'm going to find it, load upon supplies, and then make my way through the city to go and find the cable car. Yeah, pretty excited. It was I traveled here from Mostar, and I got a little coach. It was about how much? 12 euros. And then I head home in a couple of weeks. The annoying thing is, I bought this, do you know those like digital scales with a hook on the end that you hang your case on? And when I'm looking and I'm unpacking my stuff, I must have left it somewhere along the way. So I'm not looking forward to getting back through the airport. I definitely don't have the art of packing light down to a T. So I know, I'm pretty sure I'm going to weigh over on the way back. But that's a problem to worry about in a couple of weeks. But for now, let's go and explore Sarajevo. So I found my way to the graffiti shop, and as luck would have it, the guy in the shop's telling me that there's a graffiti festival on today, and I go in and he's maybe got 7 or 8 cans on the rack. He said he's been absolutely cleared out by the guys. So I picked up what I could, got a few bits and pieces, and he told me that there's another mall about half an hour away on foot, and they sell a couple of different brands. He said it's a bit cheaper than Montana, which is the brand that I picked up. So I'm kind of annoyed I bought so much. Hopefully there they've got some more colours. I've got a couple of bits. It means probably that I'm going to paint once or twice while I'm here. But he told me where the festival is as well. So I think the plan is I'm going to go
try find the mall and buy some more paint. And then I think before I head up to where I'm going to go paint, I think I might just check out the festival and see what's going on. I don't know much about it. He didn't give me much details. I wonder if it's like invite only or if there's space for the writers or whatever. But yeah, I've definitely not got enough paint here to paint. So come with me. It's an adventure today. We're figuring it out as we go along. So I went to the hardware shop and the dude in the graffiti shop, I asked him if I could film some bits, and because he'd been ransacked and he had about 10 cans left, he said he didn't want me to film. He said, why do you want to film it? I said, just because it's part of the day, but he weren't on it, but that's cool. So he said, go to the hardware shop, they've got more paint there. And he told me that they had Luge, which is an Italian graffiti spray paint brand. And I thought, happy days, Luge's my favorite. So I actually left a couple of cans there, like put a few back on the rack, took what I took from him. Made my way to the hardware shop. They obviously don't sell Luge. All they had was like a really sparse rack of like regular paint. I don't even know. I got like 3 cans of orange. I think it's going to be the ugliest piece in the world. But we've got enough paint to do a piece. That's the main thing. And kind of when in Rome, it's all part of the fun of the fair, I guess. So now I'm going to jump back on the scooter. I'm going to find my way to this. It's like an indoor arena or something. And he said that's where the graffiti festival is. So the day is getting on. It's getting on to about 1:30 now. I think it gets dark about 7, so it might have to be a bit of a speed run when I'm up there. But sod it, let's see how it goes. Gonna go check out the graffiti festival now, see if we can find some fun.
Hit that.
Yeah, cheers.
Okay. You don't see?
Just one thing.
Okay, thank you.
So I've rocked up, I've gone past security there. They were like, oh yeah, cool, you're painting, obviously, because I'm carrying this big bag of paint. Go in, I say, oh, where's the information? I talk to these guys at the information desk, and I'm saying, oh, is there any space? And it looks like there's maybe about 5 or 6 plots left. They said they need more emulsion, so they're finishing emulsioning out the spot. And the guy was being really stiff. He was like, nah, sorry, brother, there's no space. He said, there's still more people to come. I said, what if I squeeze in? Guy was like, no, because everybody needs to mark out. He says, unless your tag's on the wall, then you can't go paint. And one writer starts chiming in. He says, oh, you can paint if you get the ladder and you can paint up high. I thought, sod that, I'm not spending all day up a ladder in this heat. So a bit annoying, but it was a chance anyway. I thought it might be a long shot. So I think I'm going to have to stick to the original plan, find my way to that cable car, get up to the bobsleigh track. I didn't even want to paint there anyway. We're on the cable car, we've got the big bag of spray paint. Time now is about 2:15. And I've seen the last car down is at 7 p.m. So it doesn't leave me as much time as I would like. Normally if I was painting, I think I said in the Mexico episode, I'm always the last one done when I paint with my friends. Maybe that gives me 4 hours once I get to the wall, which is plenty of time. I'm just gonna have to blast through it. But yeah, on the cable bus now. I've actually not done any research, so I'm going to bring a little bit up on screen here, probably just try to figure out how long the line is, when the line was built. Maybe it was built for the Winter Olympics, even though the cars look brand new. I wonder if, given the Luge track was up here, if this was the mode of transportation for athletes and spectators alike. But yeah, let's take in some of the views now. It's the first time since I left my door where I just get to sit down and chill for a minute and managed to get a whole car to myself, which is a treat. Up we go.
This is Mount Trebevic, which overlooks Sarajevo with such a fraternal vigilance that the 480,000 inhabitants of the city below have come to know it almost as a member of their families. It is the site of an $8.5 million combined artificial bobsled and luge run, and the competition that will take place here today is the finals of the two-man bobsleds. This is the Great Britain sled, the number one driver, Thomas Delahunty. He's a rugby player, practices judo. His brake man is Peter Lund. They are in 18th place after 2 heats.
He had a lot of trouble in yesterday's heats with his push bar. Really threw off his concentration. He's way back in 18th place. And his teammate, Malcolm Lloyd, is about 5 spots up on him.
The heavy snow has made the course treacherous. Delahunty is a good driver, fine pilot, the British national champion.
Of course, Great Britain won the gold medal in bobsledding in 1964. Tony Nash, Robin Dixon probably won the greatest upset in the history of two-man bobsled at the Innsbruck Olympics there.
All right, so unpacking my haul here, I've got 3 of these Maxis, the big boys. Couple of Montana cans and a couple of cans of the stuff that I picked up from the hardware shop. Got myself some gloves, always a good idea. And it was quite good because, well, I say quite good. Good for me because a lot of it was kind of dogged out and messy, so it wasn't hard to find something to go over. A couple people stopping for a little chat. Had some tunes on. Bit of shade, which was nice. It was a hot day. These are those Maxis, check this. Maximum coverage. Handy as well that the thing that I found to go over had a similar background color to the purple that I was using. I've got these big wide caps on them that just, yeah, the whole can empties out in about 20 seconds.
here, the thankless task of filling with the orange from the hardware shop. Don't worry about the sweat patch. Orange is a nightmare anyway, yellow is a nightmare anyway. You can see here the coverage just isn't the best, so I'm just trying to like go back over where I've been and double up and just a bit translucent. But we make do. Ideally, you'd want to emulsion the whole wall so it was just completely flat behind, but today we're in a bit of a rush, so we're making do, rinsing out the orange. Same thing with the blue maxi here, just trying to fill it in. There's a couple of bits where I'd want to do like a cutback, you know, kind of use a thinner cap with the dark blue and cut back into some of the details in the foreground. Like these, say these light blue flames here, the top of the third sort of peak of the flame, I'd like to just tidy that up and make that a bit sharper. But with those maxis, you just stuck with that huge blowout cap on it, so I couldn't really get technical. But still, having some fun. Starting to take shape a little bit now. A couple of people stopping and chatting. Spoke to people from America, Germany, Austria, random places. One thing that was really cool was every now and again there was day trippers, there was people on little guided tours. One guy on a guided tour told his people that this was the first time that they used the same gas that they used to keep a freezer cold in these pipes that ran throughout the course, and it was the first time the technology had been used. But there was crazy heavy snowfall for like a week before the main event. So as mentioned in that little archive clip that I put in the edit, they said the snow was really crazy. And he said West Germany went on to take the gold in 1984 in the bobsleigh. But yeah, one thing that was cool was there was these little guided tours, and there was obviously people there, just tourists kind of popping through and walking the length of the track and taking pictures and stuff. But every now and then it felt absolutely completely silent, and it would come around about once every 30 minutes maybe, where there was just no one, and it was just the sound of just the woods and nothing else. And it was really nice when those little moments came. But yeah, cool day all in all, making do here. So the black that I'm using to outline is one of my favorite, probably my outright favorite graffiti product. It's Montana 2G, and it's got the same, I can't remember the name of this this element, but it's got the same stuff that they paint the underside of cars with to keep it super black. And the idea is with this that the black goes over chrome. So if you ever see silver and black graffiti, we call that chrome. And this black just covers it straight away, same as another product called Covers All, which is a bit more heavy duty. But this 2G, I find for pieces like this, it's got a really narrow, nice cap, and you can really control the pressure. So it was good fun. It was nice to use 2G again. So I was using that really for these kind of outlines, and then the bigger, bulkier bits of black, I was filling that with the black that I got from the hardware shop. Maybe there, just use a bit of the 2G, no harm done. But yeah, starting to take shape now. I love that 2G stuff. Another thing that was really interesting was the curvature of the wall. I don't think I've ever painted a wall that curves over like this. So that was kind of a challenge. Every now and then I'd try and draw a straight line and I'd have to kind of bend with the wall. But it's all part of the fun, I guess. Different kind of spot. Here I'm just adding like a shadow, a little kind of drop shadow. It's funny because throughout the day, most people, or some people would ask if they could take a picture, or oh, do you mind if we get a photo? It's like, no, obviously not. And then some people, you'd hear their footsteps padding, and then they'd suddenly come to a stop, and if you look over, they're kind of stopping to take a picture. It's always a funny one. Yeah, adding these little details here, stop and chat with this dude, start to work on these little on the sunglasses here. So here is an example of a cutback. I don't mind going over into the pink of the face, because after all the details are in on the glasses, I'm just gonna use the pink just to neaten up like this underneath and just hide it behind. I like this about spray painting, it's quite forgiving. Starting to take shape a little bit now. A couple more little details on the face, just outline these teeth. Normally I'd have a few more colours in my bag, and it's a lot easier when I'm at home and I've got a full inventory. I can take out just a bag of dregs and just have a little bit of this, a little bit of that. But here, like for the lips and the nose and then the frames of the glass, I've just had to use the colours that I've got. all part of the fun, I guess, trying to figure it out as you go along, especially when I've just got a sketch with kind of no color. I should bring my sketch up. I'm going to put my sketch on screen here. This is what I started with. Just a rough idea. But yeah, enjoying it and enjoying working with the 2G. It's really forgiving. One thing I think I said on the episode where I was painting in Mexico, one thing I really didn't realize my whole life is we've been stunk out painting in England. It's just with the weather and the lack of sunshine, it just it doesn't take to the wall. It's wet, it's drippy, you have to move really quickly. Whereas one thing I'm learning painting in these hotter countries is just you get a much nicer finish. You can really take your time with little certain bits and you're not going to catch any drips or, you know, any problems. Here, just adding the little highlights across the top. I like the white layer, it makes it stand out a little bit. Just adding a power line or the force field here around the edges. Couple more little last details, more of the shines, adding a couple little stars on there. Bling, 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 bling. Aren't we far off done here? Had a couple of cans left, but pretty much used up all the paint that I brought down with me, which was nice. It was a lot easier carrying the paint back out to the apartment than it was carrying it up the hill. Last little details, bit of stubble for your boy there. I like this time, so when the can gets to the end, you've got a nice lower pressure to work with, so you can add a few more little light details. There's my piece right in the middle of the bobsleigh track, loving life. In all its glory. Some little details. There's the dude. Shout out LC. And this is kind of cool as well. So in the couple of days after, well, literally just before I did this voiceover, I realized Red Bull UK posted this clip of Matt Jones biking down the bobsleigh track. And right at the start of the reel, you see my painting there. So I went sniffing and I found these photos from the day. This was like about 5 days ago at the time of recording. And they were featured on the Red Bull website. How cool is that? So that's where this painting ended up. Pretty buzzing with that.
Painting finished, heading back up the hill now. Made it in good time. I think, I'm not sure exactly what time I got down. I think it would have been about maybe 2:30 or something like that. But I was finished by about 5:30. I think most of the time when I paint with friends, I just spend the afternoon wittering away, chit-chatting, procrastinating. Maybe it's because I knew I was against the clock a little bit. Yeah, got finished in good time, and I'm glad that it's still daylight. The last cable car down is at 7 p.m., so that's what I was racing against. But I chilled for a little bit after painting, and now it's about 6 p.m., so didn't do too bad. So now I've got the hike back up to where the cable cars leave off, make it back down into center, drop this paint off at mine, and then I'm going to head out into the old town. Check this cathedral, look at that. Pretty cool. So, jumped inside, had a super quick shower, but oh my god, felt incredible. I needed it. Quick costume change like the Oscars, and then back out onto the strip. I'm excited, you know, this city is massive, and even though I'm only here for a couple of weeks, I'm thinking it's going to be good fun because there's a few different corners of it to explore. So I'm not mad that I'm probably going to end up making a few episodes here. I've been thinking a lot about it, you know, about like trying to change the scenery and stuff, and like you know, different cities, new locations and stuff like that. But I think it's kind of cool if, you know, to keep like a few episodes of the same city, especially showing some different sides of it. So yeah, I'm excited for that. I think there's plenty to explore. The old town looks cool. It's just warming up. There's people out just having some drinks and getting some dinner and stuff. So I'm going to go check it out. And there's a couple of things. There's a fountain where apparently if you drink from the fountain, it means that you're going to come back to Sarajevo at some point. So I might have to drink from the fountain. But yeah, we're heading into the old town. It's lively. I'm absolutely starving. I'm running on two bananas. When I went to grab the... when I got the spray paint from the hardware store earlier, it was coupled with like a little supermarket. So I jumped in there, just got like two bananas, a protein bar and a bottle of water. So I'm running on empty at the minute. I'm ready for a big munch. Not sure where I'm going to go yet. I just want to get into the heart of it, and then I'm going to start Googling and try to find somewhere. But yeah, Sarajevo by night. The call to prayer's just gone out. The sun's literally just gone down. Got a really cool view of the city from the balcony in the Airbnb. So I'm kind of buzzing. I like watching that come in. Look at this one, cool city. So yeah, into Sarajevo. Let's see what it's got for us.
Okay, Abu Zadala, in the old town, the Arabic restaurant. Found this one. I can't think what I would have been looking for online, but it looked like a nice menu. And yeah, look at this. It's Persian chicken drumsticks. These were seriously sensational. They were like, I've been thinking about them ever since. So they were, I guess maybe a little bit of brown sugar used when cooking them. I do well to look up a recipe. And just like turmeric rice and just like three sticky drumsticks. I don't know why. I feel like a king when I eat chicken drumsticks. It seems very lavish. But they were really good. The rice was sticky and plentiful. Ice cold water. You can't go wrong. The chicken was just, as you see there, just pulling off the bone. A couple of little bones along the way. Lamb skewers. Simple one, but nice meat. Nicely glazed. Some of the bread just for good measure. Coming straight off the skewer. Look at the way the rice is sticking to the chicken. It's just, oh. I've been thinking about this so much since I had this meal. Chicken there, look, just coming off the bone again. Might get a little something in your mouth, but take the end off it, you're all good. More water. Very thirsty, long day, sunny day. Lamb. Going down beautifully. Chicken. Loving life. The old town was really cool. Bunch of restaurants. I initially sat down at another restaurant, just sat at the table thinking that it was part of this. And I'm really glad I got up and moved rather than just thinking, oh, I'll just eat here anyway, because It was super, super good. Big up the Bosniaks. This was actually an Egyptian lady who ran this place. But yeah, £23.57 all in. Got a little tea at the end. Beautiful stuff.
Wow, that was spectacular. Perfect. Exactly what I needed. I feel like chips is the killer, you know. Like, I've just whacked all that. And I think because it had rice with it, I feel fine. A little bit of rice, a little bit of bread. Sometimes you don't need chips. But yeah, incredible. Sarajevo, man, what a place. I feel like I'm definitely going to be... Well, I drank from the fountain, so I will be back. That's the rules. But yeah, amazing. The old town's cool. The old town's popping. There's a lot of people in there just having dinner and chilling, doing their thing. But yeah, some place. I'm looking forward to my time here. But yeah, guys, it's come to that time to sign off. So I want to say thanks to anyone who's locked on. My people, if you're watching, clicking the link. I love you. Literally, I love you. And anyone who's just landed on this video randomly, thanks for watching. Thanks for sticking around till this point. If you want to plug in and see more of the work I do, head to the Instagram. Give me a follow there, at SamGrubArt on the Instagram. Plenty of stuff going on over there. I feel like that was one of the main things. I kind of wanted a content grind because, like I said on the last episode, sometimes my art page would just be dormant for ages. And I just wouldn't post stuff, whereas this is like, cool, I'm staying on a grind. I'm drawing stuff all the time, you know. Also, get over to the TikTok, at SamGrubArt as well. And we can see some shorts there, some snippets from the episodes and some little other bits, speedruns, 1 minute monsters. I've got my portfolio website. I'm hoping by the time this episode comes out, it's been updated. The portfolio website is samgrub.co.uk. So head over there for some bigger projects and some kind of wider pieces for clients where there's a few more bits that fit into it. Also from there, you can get to my shop, which is shop.samgrub.co.uk. So head there for all kind of prints and stickers and t-shirts and postcards. I'm back. I'm going to be doing some pop-ups around Christmas. So I'm looking at printing some new t-shirts. So that's pretty exciting. But yeah, the main thing, like I always say, I kind of want to turn this into a full-time thing and try and have enough work coming in from this that it's definitely supplementing my income. So if you want to help with that, if you've been watching along and you like the art style and you think, you know what, I've got a job for this guy, please reach out. Because that's the way I can keep eating this Syrian chicken. The email address is contactdrawingandexploring@gmail.com. If you hit me up there, we can have a chat, figure out what it is you want doing, get the work done. And I'd like if the submissions that come in through the episodes and via that email address, I can put the pen to paper during the episodes and work on stuff. And it's going to end up out in the real world. That'd be pretty cool. So, like I said, the email address, contactdrawingandexploring@gmail.com. But for now, I'm going to take myself back. I need to chill. It's been a busy week, like I said. So I think tonight I might just catch up on the football highlights and eat some snacks. Have a chilling one. But yeah, thanks to everyone who watched. I'm Sam Grubb, and that's another episode of Drawing and Exploring.